The Ford Dealers of America, who sell and service Ford cars and Ford trucks, present Bert Hillstrom, creator of Kukla, Ollie, and all the Kuklapolitan players with Fran Allison in Kukla, Fran, and Ollie.
Linwood?
Yes?
Wally, it's slightly used, pumpkin.
Well, yes, I could use it.
There you are, boy.
Okay.
How are you, dear?
Fine, how are you?
Oh, feeling much better.
Oh, good, Beulah.
Oh, we had a wonderful time. It's nothing colder than leftover Halloween. Whether to save these or not, I think they've just about seen their duty. Where the Halloween box is. Oh, wait a minute. Jackson!
Yes, Beulah?
Think Tony and Tina would like some leftover Halloween whistles?
I think they'd love them.
Linwood, would you pass these to Jack, please?
I certainly would.
Thank you. You're a dear boy.
Thank you, Beulah.
You're welcome. Linwood!
Mm-hmm.
Here's an old mask.
Well, thank you.
Looks like Bobsy.
It does.
Up for grabs! Oh, my. What a time. Didn't we have a good time, Jackson?
Wonderful.
Oh, great. So wonderful. Trick or treat. And afterwards, the Halloween dance. I'm so glad all of you helped to bring me out of my doldrums. I was really unhappy. Just shows what a state of mind can do to you. But now I feel fine. Except, of course, a little nostalgic for all the leftovers. Kind of miss Halloween. My night's howl, you know. My birthday. Yeah, feel a little older today. Kind of nostalgic when I think of it. Every year it's been the same way, day after Halloween. My thoughts go back to a heavenly dance, a moment of bliss we spent. Our hearts were filled with a song of romance as into the night we went and sang to our hearts' content. The song is ended, but the melody lingers on. Everybody in the Kuklapolitan troupe has a sort of personality of one type or another. It would seem kind of funny if we just changed. I don't think we'd be very happy. We compliment each other. At least that's what we always say. It's a very handy thing to say to someone. Especially, it's a very handy thing to say to someone, especially when you're not quite sure that you like the way they behave. When underneath it you have a little bit of criticism, really, you always say, oh, well, we compliment each other. It helps. Doesn't it, Fran?
I think so.
You weren't listening.
Yes, I was.
No, you weren't.
I was.
You weren't?
Yeah, you're all dressed up.
Yes.
Come on in.
We're going out to dinner, you too.
Who?
You.
Dinner?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm not dressed.
Well, you can very quickly get dressed, can't you?
Got your sparkly necklace on.
Yes.
Your gray chiffon.
Yes.
Oh, that's pretty.
Glad you like it.
What the?
You knew we had a guest today.
Jack Fashnow is always here.
Well, he's not really a guest. He's one of the family.
Linwood's not a guest.
No.
I didn't know we had a guest.
He's from New York. Or almost New York.
From New York. Bobsy?
No.
Glad for that. Doula was
very,
fly through the ceiling.
Very important author.
Oh, an author. You write?
Yes.
Books? Could it be? Charles Dickens?
No.
who could it be?
He lives in Mount Kisco.
I thought you said he lived in New York.
I said he lived near you, New York, almost New York. He lives in New York State.
Mount Kisco. I thought that was a shortening.
Oh, say. Well, you never can tell when you'll need him.
Mount Kisco. Mm-hmm. That's near, isn't that out near Pleasantville where Cousin Dorothy and
yes,
Cousin Marlo live?
Mm-hmm. I think it is.
Mount Kisco. Cousin Marlo and Cousin Dorothy, their family lives there, too.
That's right. His first name is an initial.
An initial? A?
No.
B? C-D-E-F?
Almost.
H.G. Wells.
No. H is right, though.
H? Alan Smith!
Yes.
Oh, I'm so dense.
So,
if you're not here.
Yes, he's here.
Where is he? Oh, well, we better be very funny.
Well, not that especially.
Well, I think we'd better because he's a humorist.
Well, that's his line of work.
No, but we better be very funny.
Well, I don't think we need to.
Well, I think we better try.
Well, what would you like to do?
Well, I could stand on my head.
Well, all right, that's your part. You don't expect me to join with you, though, will you?
Not today.
All right, fine.
You wear your slacks.
All right.
Then we'll all stand on our heads.
Okay, well, when you think of something real sparkling, you let me know.
Well, I don't want you to leave.
Well, are you going to go to dinner with us?
Where are you going?
Well, we don't know yet.
I didn't mean that the way it sounded.
Just meant, how should you dress, is that right? Mm-hmm. Well, anything you wear will be fine.
Bathrobe?
No. Well, maybe you're going to the pump room.
Well, that'd be fun. I'd love to go, but, you know, two's company.
Four's not a crowd, though.
Well, you're going.
You bet I am.
You
like my
going.
Hair. I gave it a rinse.
Yes, it glistens.
Yeah, I gave it a rinse with some stuff. Makes it a little, kind of brings out the highlights.
Mm-hmm, it looks beautiful.
Yeah, you like it?
Mm-hmm.
You look lovely.
Thank you.
Oh, golly, I love that dress. I love that sparkly necklace.
Oh, you're the one. Thank you very much.
Is that the one you wear with the pearls sometimes?
Sometimes.
I like it that way, or I like it with the pearls.
You
too.
Do?
Yes. I think I'll wear my brooch.
Your what?
Didn't know he had one.
But certainly, it was my mother's.
Oh, well, you can wear it if you want to. Where do you wear?
On my tooth.
Golly, you don't!
I could.
Yes, you could. Well, it would make a nice tie pin, too.
You gonna wear a tie?
I don't know. I just might not. I thought I might go in a sports shirt. That'll give him a little turn.
Go is right. You won't even get in.
Huh?
Think you would even get in.
Oh.
No, thank you. Maybe you would. I don't know.
Did you see the Jerry Lester show last night?
Yes, it
was.
Real George, wasn't
Real great.
All the way.
Yeah. Oh, that was funny.
Real great.
Philip Hamburger is back in my good graces again.
Was he ever out?
Well, there was a question.
I see.
But he loves Jerry Lester, and I love Jerry Lester, so things equal to the same thing are equal to each other.
Yes.
That's an old axiom.
That's nice to know. Well, well, goodness, let's not talk about dinner yet. We've got to do a show.
Yes.
We've got to be very... Ollie, come up here. Come on, Ollie.
All right.
Oh!
That even hurt me. Ollie, I'm sorry. Was it your tooth? What was it, Ollie?
Your head.
Oh, sorry. That hurt. terribly, doesn't it? Cold cloth would be good. Get him a cold cloth, Kukla.
No, no, not us. I just go put the cold glasses down.
Yeah.
Feel better?
Yeah.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
What was it you called me up about?
I didn't call.
I called.
Oh, your voices are so similar.
Mm-hmm.
What did you want?
Well, I thought since H. Allen Smith is here and everything, we ought to do something really spectacular.
How do you mean?
Well, great play or a dramatization of a novel or something.
Do you have anything in mind?
Me? Yeah, well, no, I didn't. That's what I wanted to talk to you two kids for.
Well, I'm so busy combing out the golden glints in my hair that I can hardly really think of a story. Besides, I just had stories all knocked out of my head, I think. However, I'd be willing to go along with you two kids.
Well, I'll do what I can, but I don't have anything special in mind either.
Well, Kook, I guess it's up to you.
Well, I thought we might do, we could do a great, we could do a wonderful show about Paris.
Well, I'd never been in Paris, and I think to do something like that, you should really...
Oh, no, that's not necessary.
Well,
they do it on television all the time.
Well, I know.
So all you have to do is start out with C'est la vie, and then you end up with a couple of cute little expressions like Cherchez la femme or Mon amour. Paris. Like that. Jack, have we got any French songs cleared?
No, we didn't clear them in time. Already.
Well, that settles that.
Yes, there
let's
we go.
Let's move back to the United States.
Well, let's see.
Well, let me see. Do you think we could do a show on, how about, would you want to do anything on space travel?
No.
I wouldn't. Not today.
No, that's right. You're not dressed for it.
We could do something on, you have your lovely dress and everything. We could do a very sophisticated drama. Something rather Noah Cowardish, you think?
You mean?
Yes.
Oh, no, not that. Anything but that.
It's true. Brad, you've been a brick.
About the whole beastly thing?
Yes. How's that sound?
Oh, it doesn't have the snap. None of the snap.
I know. Too bad. Well, perhaps we should try something. Yeah. What have we got cleared? Any Noel Coward songs today?
No Noel Coward.
Well, let me think. You can always think, here we are again.
Yeah, we could do that.
Variations.
What about the, what about Indians? Could we do an Indian show?
Any Indian? No. His face fell. He reached for the tom-tom. Well, let me see. What could we do?
Well, let me see.
If we can think long enough, we won't have to do anything.
That's true. Let's try
it. Let's all think. Linwood is not thinking.
Linwood, you're not thinking.
Go to your room. And leave the earphones here. Not going to have you in there. Hooking those earphones up to your crystal set. He always does. He goes in there and he hooks the earphones up to the crystal set. He's got a crystal set hooked onto the bed spring.
Yes.
Yeah. And he sits there and he listens to the program. No, sir. When I send you to your room, you're going in there in silence. No supper. All righty. Where were we?
I was just thinking. I'm going to write some plays that we can do here, you and Kukla and I. And like Dagmar does on the Jerry Lester show, she gets all the good parts. And she writes them right on the spur of the moment, so they get to read them off the paper.
Kukla, we've got to be firm right now, because this is the beginning of the end.
Yesterday, last night, she taught school on the 46th floor.
Mm-hmm. Very amusing. We thought it was very funny, too.
I'm going to have some fun. You wait and see.
Very funny show.
Yes, very funny. Well, let's get on to our own show today, shall we?
Want me to write a play?
Sidetracker.
No, Fran, no. We don't want you to go to that trouble of writing a play.
No trouble at all.
Okay, write one.
Oh, well, I know I won't do it.
See, it always works. Caller bluff, see? It always works. It's the same old thing. I'll tell you what. Let's all repair to the fair, to our drawing room.
And think.
No, and draw.
Oh. Well... You draw off there.
I have some new crayons, and I just love to scribble a little.
Oh, wow, you're doing that again.
In the world if I could do that.
Try it.
Oh, I did.
Don't try it today. You won't be able to go out for dinner. Either that, you come in walking in backwards and facing forward. Very strange. I did
nowhere.
That.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah, I did that once. I did that one time before I went out, and I tell you, I really, I'm going to do that at the pump room tonight.
There you
go. There we ought to get them.
Well, I'll see you in a little while.
All right. If you get an idea first, you come running in.
All right.
Clipperty clop, clipperty clop. Don't forget now.
No.
Kukla, we can't let her write a play. You know, that Dagmar does get all the good parts.
I know, I know. Jerry just has to stand there and he just has the two lines.
Yeah. Can't allow that.
Well, Fran's entitled to some of the good parts.
Yeah, but see, we'll write it so that, you know, so that we shine a little bit. We don't want to be in the background in Harley, do we? Do we?
Well...
You're weakening! I knew you'd weaken. That's the trouble with you kids. Pretty girl, turn your head. You got to be strong. Strong, Kook. We are made of sterner stuff. Aren't we?
Well, if you say so, Harley, I'll hold out.
Got to be very strong and very high-minded about this whole thing. Polite, sweet, diplomatic, charming is all. But firm.
Firm!
The song is ended, but the melody lingers on. You and the song are gone, but the melody lingers on. Someone asked me a question today. They said, what are you going to do now that Halloween is over? No pumpkins to carve. Well, sir, I had a ready answer. Thanksgiving is coming, and I have a wonderful little treatise on how to carve a turkey.
No, you don't.
Well, I've got something even better that I can talk about. Something that really means a great deal to me. Wait right here. You bet I have something better to talk about. Look at this. The 1951 Ford. You bet. Oh, say, gracious sake. Why would any rabbit in the entire United States talk about Halloween or Thanksgiving or anything else when they have the fine new 1951 Ford to talk about? Oh, look at that. Yes, sir, the 1951 Ford offers luxury that lasts. Beauty. Beauty that stays in style. And years and years and years of economical, carefree driving. Oh, I'm so proud of my little 1951 Ford with all its wonderful beauty. Oh, look at that. Oh. They're all nice and shiny. Oh, you'll see us Kukopolitans driving all winter long and all the spring and this summer in our 1951 Fords. Just keep your eyes open and just watch old Fletcher Rabbit. Of course, I like the convertible because it's easier in my ears, you see. Naturally, I just pull the top back like that, and my ears are free to flow and flap in the wind. Say, here's something else about the 1951 Ford. Did you know that the 1951 Ford offers a great new optional extra? Well, I bet you didn't. I just bet you didn't. You know what that optional extra is? The Ford-O-Matic Drive, the automatic transmission that eliminates 92% of normal driving motions. Just think that over. And you better ask your friendly Ford dealer about that Ford-O-Matic Drive when you go down to see the new 1951 Ford. He'll tell you all about it. And I think it would be a very good idea if you would go down to see him and see and drive the new 1951 Ford. You know something? You can pay more, but you can't buy better. Well, sir, guess I'll be on my way for a little drive. See you later.
What?
I haven't got an idea yet. You get one first.
I have one.
Oh, my buddy. Fran! We have an
I
idea.
I almost have my play finished.
Oh, that's too bad. We'll do it another day, won't we? Won't we?
There's a part for you. There's a part for you. That other volume over there is mine. Are we ready?
Two words.
Two rows. I am Magnolia. You are Reginald. You can be Ravenol. You have both
I'm what?
Ravenol.
Oh, yes, I'm quite
you
hungry.
Have both just or from it, one of the two. Now, you have just asked me to marry you, so have you. I'm refusing both of you. So you say, but Magnolia.
Who, me?
You, but.
But Magnolia!
No, Reginald, I cannot marry you. But I will be a sister to you, and because I know you would want to see your sister well-dressed, I will keep the mink coat and the beautiful pearls that you gave me. And you asked me to marry you.
But, Magnolia, will you marry me?
No, Ravenel, I cannot marry you, but I will be a sister to you, too. And since I know you are very good to your family, I will keep the old yacht which you gave me and the seven cars.
Do you mind if I ad-lib?
No, that's all right, but I won't let you get very far. Now, what I don't have is the closing speech. So if you want to ad-lib while I go and write the closing speech...
No, that's all right,
Fran. No, you go ahead, and I'll finish.
Close your mouth.
Hmm?
Close your mouth.
Oh, didn't know it was open. That girl's pretty fast in the dialogue.
She is fast. Good writer, too.
Fast writer. But Magnolia, will you marry me?
But Magnolia.
Who's it that ran in and picked up that script?
Lawrence Langner.
For the Theater Guild?
Yeah, no, it couldn't be.
Oh, no, it couldn't be. He, maybe the writing's good. Maybe we have a golden talent here. That could be. Maybe if we're kind of like producers. I could be Svengali.
No, let's not get into that. No, that'd be too complicated.
That'd be real wonderful. Maybe we could do a, like, maybe we could do like As You Like It, a wonderful play. We're going to do that Friday.
Oh, that's good. Hope Mr. Langer sees that.
I hope so, too.
How's your closing speech coming, Fran?
I can't get much farther. I know who I'll marry, though.
Fran?
Yes?
We do have an idea for show. I don't know if we could do it or not.
Well, I'll go along with your idea till I finish mine.
See, KOB-TV in Albuquerque, New Mexico is celebrating its first anniversary.
Today?
Uh-huh, and Tom Pepperday and George Johnson wrote us about it. And so I thought we could do a westward ho or southwestward ho sort of play.
Well, every time we do those westerns, I wind up with such miserable parts.
I think we could get a real good part. Here, I've been looking up...
I'm accustomed now to real great roles.
I've been looking up in the World Book about Albuquerque in New Mexico.
Well, I know it's in the central part of the state.
That's right. It's on the Rio Grande.
Yes.
But I've been reading about the history.
Oh, look, Spaniards. It's about the Spaniards coming up. Oh, say, the Pueblo Indians. Oh, say, we could... Wait.
Well, I'll tell you, I'll take the part of
We could wear hats like this.
I'll take the part of the Indian who sits by the railroad station and sells the postal cards and all the beaded bags and everything.
Oh, no,
you
That'll
be a real easy part.
No, no, you want something real exciting. And this is going to be a real drama.
How about Spanish songs, Jack?
No Spanish songs, no.
Well, let's get to the later history.
University of New Mexico is in Albuquerque, isn't it?
Yes. We could do a college show.
I don't feel up to a college show today, I don't think.
Oh, I'll go look.
Let me see.
Big Railroad Center.
Yeah, and it's all about, a beautiful country, the Carlsbad Cabins in New Mexico.
Oh, yes. Wonderful climate there.
Yeah. You do something about the Santa Fe Trail.
Say, I understand that at one time, gypsies went through Albuquerque. And so I thought it might be a good idea if we did the Bohemian Girl.
Oh,
so I brought my tambourine.
Just take it right back.
You don't like music, that's all.
Well, let me see now. Well, Jack, what have we got cleared today?
Hi, Bill Biddle, Lemonade,
Oh,
Them
Dudes. Oh, Them Dudes!
Oh, Them Dudes! We could do that! Yeah. Ollie! Oh!
I already, superseded your, idea. I've got my, kerchief on. You ready, Francis?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
You wish you had your hat now?
Oh, I don't have a hat.
I got a hat. Just wait for me.
Okay.
Oh, we can start anyway.
Oh, them dudes.
Oh, them dudes.
They're a-doing our dance.
They're a-doing our dance.
Them city dudes.
Them city dudes.
They're a-doing our dance.
They're a-doing our dance.
Down at the nightclubs, look what I found. Do-si-do and all hands around
them dudes.
nightclubs, what did I hear about a jug and a fiddle? They was playing by ear.
Them dudes, them dudes, them big city dudes, they were stealing our stuff. Oh, the coyotes, sad and awful flossy.
They call out all the posse.
This here kind of thieving's got to stop.
We'll give them fair warning.
If they don't stop by morning,
we'll retaliate by taking a pop.
On account of them dudes,
oh, them dudes,
they're a-doing our dance.
They're a-doing our dance.
Them city dudes,
them city dudes,
and their uncles and aunts,
and their uncles and aunts.
Down at the nightclubs, look at them go, all hands round and do-si-do.
Playing guitar and the musical saw, jumping our claim on the turkey in the straw.
Hey,
look at them varmints wearing our garments down to the Levi pants. Oh, them dudes, them dudes, them big city dudes, they're doing our dance.
Now, if we could just think of something to do, we'll be all right.
Yeah, now let me see. Now, if we could work out, tell you what we could do. We could have a... Oh, I got it. We could have a real wonderful... We could get the covered wagon, and then we'll all get in the covered wagon, see?
All right.
And we'll start on the Santa Fe Trail. Now, Kukla, you can be the villain.
I don't want to be the villain.
Cooperation, you see?
Could we go by way of Kansas City? I have a very good friend there.
We could try it that way.
Let's go that way.
We could go that way. I would rather go another way.
How do you want
to? I would rather go down. We should take a boat from New York. We should all be... That gives us a chance to do a big scene about sailing. Then go down through the Gulf of Mexico and land at Veracruz and come up through Mexico.
How is the weather now?
Well, it should be very nice.
Well, all right. We'll go then.
I know how we're really going to go if you want to know it.
Tell me.
Well, this is something you haven't forgotten, I hope. Remember, the one fine car in the low-priced field is the 1950...
Ford!
Hello, this is Ollie again. I have a very special announcement for you. There's a real surprise in store for you at your Ford dealers this Friday. It's the 1951 Ford with 43 new look-ahead features that offer luxury that lasts, beauty that stays in style, and years of economical, carefree driving. For 1951, Ford offers a great new optional extra. Ford-O-Matic Drive. The automatic transmission that eliminates 92% of normal driving motion. See and drive the new 1951 Ford. You'll agree you can pay more, but you can't buy better.
Kukla, Fran, and Ollie came to you from Chicago. NBC Television.